Well, folks, Republican Senator Rick Scott, the chair of the National Republican Senatorial Committee, the fundraising arm of the Senate Republicans, is back bright-eyed and bushy-tailed from his luxurious time off the coast of Italy on a luxury yacht. He's back from that vacation and dang it, he is mad. Apparently he didn't get much rest while on the Italian coast. Maybe it has something to do with the fact that all the Republicans in the Senate are wondering where their $145 million went that Rick Scott was in charge of and now can't account for. So that's probably, you know, kept him up a couple of nights. But he's taking out his anger at the wrong person, because he is taking out his anger on Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell. And in a recent op-ed published in the Washington Examiner, Rick Scott had this to say about certain people. He wouldn't name anybody by name because he's a friggin' coward. But it's very clear he's talking about Mitch McConnell. He said, "Unfortunately, many of the very people responsible for losing the Senate last cycle are now trying to stop us from winning the majority this time by trash-talking our Republican candidates. It's an amazing act of cowardice, and ultimately, it is treasonous to the conservative cause. Giving anonymous quotes to help the Washington Post or the New York Times write stories trashing Republicans is the same as working with the Democratic National Committee." Wow. You seem a little angry there, Rick. Are people asking you too many questions about what the hell happened to that money? Did you lose it? Did you take it? What happened to it, Rick? Why don't you answer those questions before accusing other people of being treasonous to the Republican Party? Because you're the guy in charge of the money and all the Republicans want to know where the hell the money went. But again, as I said, it is very obvious that he is talking about Mitch McConnell. Mitch McConnell has been fairly vocal about the fact that Republicans aren't going to win back the Senate because they've got such crappy candidates out there. And there's likely a lot of truth to that. Right now, 538 averages show that Democrats are probably going to pick up 3 seats in the Senate. 3 seats in the Senate. Two of them, of course, being Ohio and Pennsylvania, where you have J.D. Vance and Dr. Oz running respectively, both doing horribly in the polls. Down in Georgia, Republicans had hoped they were going to flip that seat, but it looks like Warnock still does hold a slight edge in most polls. As I've previously talked about, there's one poll that shows Walker actually winning, so that one, I'd classify it as a toss-up right now, to be honest with you. But even winning back one seat and losing three others still gives Democrats a 52-48 advantage in the Senate, which of course would prove Mitch McConnell right. You have bad candidates. Even Herschel Walker, even in the poll where he's winning by 2 points, he still has a much higher unfavorable rating than Raphael Warnock. Dr. Oz is hugely unpopular in the polls. J.D. Vance, not doing well either. Blake Masters out in Arizona. They thought they could unseat Mark Kelly. Probably not going to happen because he's a total failure. These are Republicans, by the way, all of them that Donald Trump himself has endorsed. Hell, even Ron Johnson, incumbent in Wisconsin, is losing in the polls to his Democratic challenger. Things aren't looking good for the Republican Party. And Mitch McConnell, contrary to what Rick Scott says, that he's a cowardice, you know, treasonous little snake, Mitch McConnell's the only Republican right now living in reality. He's the only one sounding those alarm bells that, hey, guys, things aren't good for us. And meanwhile, Rick Scott says, how dare you, you coward? But I'm not going to mention you by name because I'm the real coward. How dare you say things are bad? Things are wonderful and great and everything is perfect and we have lots of money to spend. Sounds like you're trying to cover up for something, Rick. Sounds like you're trying to paint a picture of a rose on a giant dog turd. Because that's what the Republicans are left with in terms of candidates this election cycle. A bunch of dog turds that nobody seems to want. For obvious reasons, of course. I know what a lot of you out there are thinking. You're thinking, wouldn't it be amazing if you could wear the Ring of Fire logo across your chest? Well, now you can just head on over to our Teespring page to find some awesome merch we're offering for our viewers. We have more designs that are going to be added in the near future, so just follow the link in the description or take a peek at the shelf of merchandise under this video. Thanks for watching.